So I guess I think of a drug as something that has a defined pharmacology. And so a chemical that can act on a set of receptors that have been defined and that we can then make chemicals that mimic or block the action of that chemical. So that's how I think of a drug. And so drugs can be medicines, drugs can be illicit substances and so forth.
A drug is something that you take deliberately, even though it can injure you because you have a reason to take it. So the drug is a toxicant that we use for one of its effects, being very careful of those effects that can kill us or injure us. To the toxicologist, there's no difference whatever between a toxicant and a drug. They're the same thing.
So a drug could be either a man-made compound or it could be a naturally occurring compound. Lots of drugs are extracted from plants and things. But a drug is something that has a therapeutic use. So it has some beneficial properties for treating symptoms or of a disease or infectious process or something like that.
I don't know how old this is. The Twinkie defense, I think it was someone who tried, I don't know if it worked either, but the defense for, I think it was a murder, was that he had eaten too many Twinkies and was so hyper that he killed somebody. Twinkies became a drug, in my mind. If you have too many Twinkies, then it's a drug. And certainly that's what he tried to convince the jury. I don't think it worked.
I think a drug can be generally defined as you know, this exogenous or outward substance that's taken into the body and has the potential to have some sort of an effect. And any of these toxins or toxicants can be drugs, depending on, or most of these toxins can be drugs depending on the intent of the individual who's taking it.
A toxicant is a man-made chemical as opposed to a naturally occurring toxin. So it's a chemical that's artificially produced that is toxic, that has negative health effects.
A toxicant is something that we're exposed to from the environment. A toxin is something that actually has a toxic effect on the brain. So it doesn't have to necessarily be something that we're exposed to environmentally. So we can use toxins even experimentally, because it's going to disrupt function. So it has actions that would cause damage or some kind of damaging effect is what I think of a toxin.
Let me begin with toxins. And this is a colleague of mine, Larry Hansen, was very definite about this. A toxin is the product of an animal or a plant. So I can talk about algal toxins, I can talk about snake venoms as toxins, but he had a real thing about not using the word toxin for anything that was not the byproduct of an animal or a plant or fungus. In other words, a natural product. Well, so he used toxicant instead. In common toxicological parlance, the two words are used interchangeably. We talk about toxins when we mean toxicants, so that I will talk about the organophosphates as toxins. Well, strictly speaking, they're toxicants.
Pretty much any chemical can be viewed as a toxin if it's in excess, and that's where you get to the real issue. So if it's oxygen will kill you. High oxygen levels also will lead to brain damage. Because the same thing that leads to better metabolism in one case, if it is overdone, leads to bad metabolism and cell death. So you can overdose on oxygen, you can overdose on water.
Yeah, I don't know. That doesn't really have much meaning for me, separate meaning, toxicant versus toxicant. And I guess same thing with poison, really. I mean, a poison is a toxin. Sometimes we use the word poison to talk about a chemical that produces a toxic effect. So I struggle with what that might mean.
A poison, that's not a technical term. That's common English, and people use it as a word for something that is bad for you or that will kill you. Not a food, not a drug, but something that you shouldn't be eating. And so that would include, you know, pesticides. It would also include plants that are poisonous. All sorts of things are poison. And it would include ink, for example. You know, anything that you shouldn't be eating that is bad for you.
One of the oldest sayings in toxicology is the dose makes the poison. So, in other words, anything could be a poison if you take a large enough dose of it. Even table salt could be a poison if you eat enough table salt. So, a toxin or a toxicant could be a poison, or something that you think is more mundane could be a poison if you intake enough of it.
There's a story I remember reading a few years ago about a girl who was brought to the hospital because she consumed massive amounts of salt. And they figured she had some psychological problem, and the first thing to do was to wean her off of salt. So they did, and she died. It turned out that her problem was that she couldn't hold salt. So for her, eating an amount of salt that would kill you or me was what she needed to sustain living. So for her, it was not a toxin. It was more an essential nutrient, a vitamin. She had to have it. And of course, her biology was different, but it captures some of the issues, I think, about trying to understand whether something is or is not a toxin. The answer is it depends.